First, I want to talk about queue templates. Every time I make a queue, a group queue, audio queue, or any of the queue types, that queue is getting copied from the Workspace's queue template. To edit a queue template, you go to File, Workspace Settings, Templates, Queue Templates, and select the queue type you want to change. For example, I like my audio queues to start blue and set to auto continue. That doesn't necessarily make sense as a default, but I want to demonstrate that when I make a new audio queue, both of those settings appear in the audio queue when I make a new one. And that's true whether I make an audio queue by dragging a file in from the desktop or make a new one using the queue bar. In addition to queue templates, QLab also has workspace templates. Now that I've made my audio queue template exactly how I want it, I want all of my workspaces to start with that audio queue template in it. So, because this workspace is ready to go, I can go to File, Save as Template, and name it Now, I want to set that template as my default template. To do that, I go back to File, Workspace Templates, Manage Templates, select my template, set it as the default, and click Done. Now, anytime I make a new workspace and create a new audio queue, it uses the template that I made in my default workspace. When making a workspace template, keep in mind that it's copying an entire workspace. So if I have a complete queue list, it'll copy all of the queues that are already in my queue list into the template, which you may not want. So when you're making a workspace template, probably you want to do some cleanup on whatever workspace you were originally working on. QLab also has the ability to export and import settings. As an example, I've customized my keyboard mapping to my liking. I can export that keyboard map by going down to the bottom here and clicking Export. By default, all of the settings are selected. I can uncheck all settings and select just keyboard controls. When I click Export, I can save it to a file name of my choice, and now I can import that file anywhere I like. To show an example of importing, I'm going to first use the Import button to reset to QLab's defaults. I clicked Import, and now I'm selecting from QLab defaults and selecting keyboard settings. And now you can see that the keyboard shortcuts have returned to their default settings. Now, just for a demonstration, I'm clicking Import from Settings file, selecting my preferred settings file, selecting that I want only the keyboard controls to import. The rest of them, which aren't available in that file, are grayed out. Now you can see that my preferred keyboard shortcuts are now pulled up. Another and potentially more common example of this is if I go into my light patch, I don't have anything in here, but I have an open workspace that has a light patch that I want to reuse. So I can click Import from Workspace, and all of my open workspaces are listed. I know that the patch I want is in the Dawn Again workspace. I can choose from any of the settings in Dawn Again, but I'm just going to choose my light patch. Click Import. And now you can see that my entire light patch has been imported into this workspace. Workspace settings import and export was inspired by user needs. People asked for it, and we built it for QLab 5. So I hope you like it.